Hello, and we are back here for episode 2 of Minecraft Let's Play series. Now, since last time, I've gotten a few more worlds, as you can see. I believe last time we were playing on this one, but we're actually going to be playing on a different world this time. And I'm going to walk you through what changed and what's new and what exactly it is I'm doing today. So, as usual, there's no particular specific task that I want to accomplish, other than, obviously, just get through the game, survive, collect ores, and things of the sort. Oh, what's going on? So, to begin with, started a new world, playing with my friend, and we got started a little bit, used a little bit of creative to get some things going, mainly because, one, we didn't know what a lot of these things were, so we just figured we'd spawn them, and then, two, we wanted to start a new world because we had another world and it was kind of crappy, but, so I'm going to be playing on this one today. So, yeah, first and most obvious is the experience tree. It's kind of just everywhere. And then, you know, we've got a couple other trees over here. I went and planted a persimmon tree, hoping it would be some kind of fruit-bearing tree that you could actually eat. Little did I know. I just don't have any sound right now. Great. Anyways, I planted these trees just to see, hopefully they were fruit-bearing. That one obviously wasn't. Planting this orange one, I've yet to figure out how it is you get the fruit off of it. So, that's a work in progress. And we got this fruit tree, grapefruit, yep. I don't know, same thing with this one. This is an orange tree, I have no idea. And this is a banana tree. I have no clue as to why it can't, like, anything. So I'm pretty sure this one, yeah, we have cocoa with them. Like, what is that all about? What? Oh, they're bananas. I was wrong. So, that's that. Then if you look down there, you can see there's another experience tree. That one, I don't remember what that tree was called. Maybe it was like, transformation? Tree of transformation, I think? And then, you know, we just got just a few other trees just playing down there just to see what they would do. I must say, my favorite tree, though, definitely is the miner's tree. I believe it's found exclusively in creative. You can only get it through creative mode. But it's a pretty fun tree. Oh, and that up there, that's the tree of sorting. It sorts your inventories. It works and it doesn't. It works in the fact that it sorts them. Like, I have it sitting up there so it would affect my chests. That was a bad idea, because the chests that I have up there were all screwed up as soon as I turned it on. But anyways, on with the trees. There is a tree called the Miner's Dream. And what it does, I don't know if you've noticed, I have these spots with just random materials everywhere. That's actually done by the core of the miner's dream. I don't have any of them on me now, but... And there we have a little Oculus that started on Ars Magica 2. And some spells and such with our Arcane Compendium. So right now we're heading down to the mine. I'm going to show you guys what exactly it was that I did with my cores. Oh, and then... One of my favorite parts of this, they got these rope ladders, they make it so easy. I literally threw one block down to the top, and it covered all the way down to the bottom. And I did the same thing for my mine. But anyways, down here I grabbed a few cores out of creative. Yeah, I know I'm a cheater, don't worry about it though. And I threw them down just to see exactly how effective they were. Well, I don't know about you guys, but I think they're pretty effective. Maybe. Oh, there's a few spots. Oh, no, that one. Yeah, that one's good now. So, I literally have three of them down here, and this was a whole square of openings, and it just continually pulls stuff out. So, I've just been walking down here, you know, grabbing all this stuff, and just piece by piece bringing them up to the top. Eventually going to space. Because going to space is pretty cool. It's going to be difficult, mainly because I have yet to find a supply of oil, but you can get around that. So, right now I'm kind of just gathering material. haven't started the Galacticraft area of this mod pack, but just kind of gathering everything and in hopes that overall it will be useful. So yeah, there's about 4 billion types of ores that are down here. Mainly, I hate how many though, like, there's so many mod packs in this, which I don't mind. It's just when it comes to mining, like, for example, like, there's, let me see if I have my inventory. Look, I got this tin ore from Galacticraft, and I have another tin from Industrial. Let me tell you, that gets annoying. But, yeah, what can you do? Luckily, they're all interchangeable, and you can use each one individually. Like, they would all work the same way. They just don't stack together. So, it gets kind of annoying, but it still works. So, moving on, let's see. We'll get some emeralds, some aluminum, copper, more aluminum. Oh, no, I'm just kidding. That's tin. Copper and tin. One thing I didn't like, though, the tin, aluminum, sometimes they're very hard. Sometimes it's hard to distinguish between them unless they're, like, directly next to each other. Or maybe it's just me. Maybe I'm just a special person. I just can't distinguish between the two, but amethyst. Alright. But, anyways, you know, I think they're kind of hard to distinguish between. That gets annoying because both of them are needed for Galacticraft. In one of my other worlds, I played around with Galacticraft a bit. We got the first few steps of building a space shuttle, and then we quit out on it because the world was just a mess. Because we didn't know what Galacticraft was, we just looked up the steps to it and just started going at it. But so needless to say, everything we put down was just in one little area, and it got real bad real quick. But, you know, there's so many things down here. We got, like, uranium. I'm pretty sure with uranium you can make bombs. Like, if you combine it with TNT or gunpowder or whatever, you can make, like, nukes out of it. But I'm not going to be using it on that because I'm pretty sure you can also use it to make, like, super ore. Not like a super ore, but more like, it's half, like, used, half of it's used to craft. Yeah. It is needed to craft, like, best tools. With, like, I think it's uranium and titanium. I found quite a bit of uranium. The titanium, it's been a little less. And look, we found some Cinnabon. Never forget. It's always Cinnabon. Never will it be Cinnabar or whatever. What is it? Yeah, Cinnabar. It will never be Cinnabar. It's Cinnabon. Cinnabon for life. Maybe that's why I should name the series Cinnabon for Life. You know what? That's what I'm gonna do. It has been settled. It has been decided. This shall be the Cinnabon Let's Play series. You will see in the video name as soon as I upload this. And all the people looking at it from the beginning should be like, what is Cinnabon? Like, why? But it sucks for them because they didn't see my first video. And leave a like. Awesome. Leave a subscribe too if you really want to be cool. Be my first subscriber. And who knows? Be my first subscriber. Maybe I'll even put this up as a server and let you join me on it. Who knows? I'm just grabbing some stone right now just so I can fill in these gaps in the floors. Those really bug me. Most people they don't, but I feel like after you play Minecraft, you are a true Minecraft player when squares not filled in bug you. The fact that I have to fill it in with cobblestone kind of bugs me, but there's only so much you can do. You win some, you lose some. Alright, let's get this iron out so we can get the diamonds. It's funny because now I'm playing, and ever since I started this mod pack, you know, I got to diamonds pretty relatively quickly in one of the other worlds, but diamonds really aren't that awesome in this one. Amethyst is where it's at. And it's funny, because amethyst is like, it's not like abundant, but once you find it though, each block drops like anywhere from 1 to, I think, 3 is what I've gotten. So, I mean, you know, you find it, and then you're pretty much pretty golden, you know. Oh, finding some lead. Lead, what do we do with lead? I don't know yet, but I bet you smelt it down. We'll figure out something with it. Maybe we'll make bombs without uranium. Make a lead bombs. Maybe we'll put it in some paint and poison some people. Who knows? See, like, right now, I'm just blindly mining everything. Like, look at this. I've been down here for maybe, what, 5 minutes, and my inventory's almost full. And it's all different stuff. Mining all the ores. Alright, I'm gonna get a few more blocks of, let's see, whatever this is. Sapphire. Whoop-de-doo. I'm pretty sure those are pretty useless. Although, I mean, I've been wrong before, because I'm still learning about this mod pack, but I'm gonna grab a few more. What just hurt me? Oh, dude. Oreberry. Nice. Pick that up. Alright, almost done. Just filling these squares. Look at that, my inventory's full already. Just throw this down somewhere. What don't I need? Put one torch down. Alright, cool. We're gonna head back up with my full inventory. And I'll show you guys from my house. Every time I come down here, like, except for this one time, obviously, this area's been cleared. Like, I clear it out before I go back up, and I clear it up just so I can see exactly what it is that... Oh my gosh. Struggle bus for reals. Alright, let's go back up to my house. First thing I'm going to show you guys, though, is where I keep all my ores. I've been down here a few times before this, and let's just say I am in no shortage of really anything, except for titanium, otherwise I'd have ultimate stuff. Pretty sure. I might have to look in the elevator because I don't think they might have those in this game. Up to the height of my house and then get a roller coaster going, shoot me all the way over my house. And you know what? I don't know. We're gonna keep going. I guess. Got some raw silicon. Just for you guys, we're gonna put it on easy. Not much of a fighter, I guess, with Minecraft. I don't like running around killing mobs. Occasionally it's fun, but normally I keep it on peaceful just because the hunger bar really gets to you. Especially when you're deep in the mines, and I have not even close to a form of, like, food yet. Which is why I put those trees down, but here we go. Ores. Many ores. Those are kind of like ores, right? And then over here I put everything that's not necessarily... Basically anything that's not an ore that you mine like that. So. And then in these chests is where I put the finished products. Like, 56 copper. Tin. So yeah, I started smelting some stuff just to get Galacticrep going a little bit. And that needs more wood. So yeah, I got lots of everything. Keep tin and aluminum in the same chest, which I'd be willing to bet that's going to be confusing, since they look so similar. Alright. Lead. Let's put it in the iron chest. Why? Because we can, and it's free. Alright, let's go outside real quick. Just kidding. Number one. First order of business. I'm going to need 2 of these. And we're gonna go make a sword. Because you know what? Without that sword, we're gonna be screwed. So why? Because I put it on easy. It gets pretty hard on easy. 2 sticks. Just kidding, I only need 1. Come on. Yes, amethyst sword. Alright. Banana. Alright. do we need next? What shall we do? Oh, I know what I need. I need bark. So that's the tree. We need the bark. At the beginning of this world, I went and I accidentally planted a redwood tree. If you don't know what that is, good. Those, no. Redwood trees are a pain in the butt. The size that they grow is just terrible. It makes you want to cry. I grew it on accident and then realized that it was not going to work out very well because the tree was just... We're just going to put it at they're bigger than the experienced trees. And I'll show you just a second here. Those are all full. The experience tree is the tree that happens to be well right there, but the size is pretty big. So it's a pretty large tree, but redwood trees, those are not trees to be trifled with. Things need to start growing more bananas. But, it's food before we head out. Snag all the apples. I don't know if you guys have noticed yet, which I really hope so, otherwise you haven't been paying attention. I live up in the mountains, because the mountains are where everything hides. You know, all the ores and stuff. Best place to look is inside the mountains. So obviously, I put myself up on a mountain because I figured, hey, I'd be up on a mountain, so might as well, I could just dig straight into it and get ores. Then, I just like living up in mountains. Don't know why. Always have just mountainous areas. I've always been my bane, I guess you could call it. I hate salt though. I don't know why I'm buying this right now. Salt is such a pain in the butt. It's all the only use I've found for it so far is I believe you can use it to with food, maybe? To like preserve meat or I don't know, something stupid like that. But there's so much of it. And every time you like cook it, you get salt pieces, I guess you could call them. It's just annoying because they fill up your chests and inventory and stuff extremely quickly. And you can't just throw a stack of 64 inside. Can't throw it inside an oven and just leave it because after 8 blocks it's melted, you have to go back and pull them out. And it's just a pain. It's a pain. I figure I'll move it, so maybe this core will pull some more things over here. Ooh, order, if you still don't know that I've found any of that yet. This world is... We need more order in this world. As far as I know, salt can only be used for cooking. Like I said, 41 blocks, that's like... Five stacks of salt. I don't even know what to do with one stack of salt. And look at this, these will turn to nine-ish stacks. A little bit less than that. It uses my chest where I keep all my spawn eggs and my shards. Alright, so let's go through. You know, I have dried cow, pretty lame spawn egg. Dragonfly, still pretty lame. Dried wolf, those would be useful if I had any bones, but I would play on a peaceful, so. Allosaurus, I've never seen one in the wild before, so probably not the most ideal thing to fight. Terrible Terror, the name says enough. Crystal Cow, it's just a cow that looks a little interesting. Sea Monster, Criminal, Dry Creeper, Baryonyx. Endernight. That's a little, that's a worrying thing. Caterkiller. Lurking Terror. I don't even know how to say that. We're just gonna. So that's what I got so far. It's the beginning of my work. Join me again. Episode 3. Maybe this time, who knows? Episode 3 might actually be soon after episode 2 and on this world. Who knows? This is the Dirty Dirks signing off.